Futures and options on futures trading involve substantial risk and is not a suitable investment for all types of investors. Past results are not necessarily indicative of future results. When I use the word I in this video, it refers to what I teach in my charting course or what I offer in my twice daily oral and written updates. Prices shown on charts and quote boards are in real time and take into account all known activity up to this point in time. And if you'd like to read more of this disclaimer, simply hit the pause key on your video player. Good day, all. Ira Epstein of Linn & Associates with your metals market update for this Wednesday. And this is the 30th of October, 31st of October. I said that wrong. 31st, Halloween, 2018. And we're getting on later in the day into the 240s. So I figured I'll do this right now. You know, you're going to finish around the 1215 level in the gold market. Silver's right in this neighborhood. I've already seen the settlement prices and copper down. I was on Fox Business News 15, 20 minutes ago. President was on right before we were waiting in the wings to go on. And he said what it's all about. He said the stock market's got a lot left in it to the upside if he can retain Congress. If he can't and he should lose control, watch out, there'd be a problem. I don't think words were better spoken. He understands what's going on here, and so should you. So while we've had a heck of a two-day bounce in the stock market, it's a bounce. 2 days don't make a trend. Understand that. We lost the downside momentum when the slow stochastics turned. But what was interesting is how the gold and the silver and the copper have let go. If you were watching China's numbers come out today, you understand what's going on here. Their whole economy is really grinding to a halt. So if you think they don't get hurt by what the U.S. does, and I've heard analysts say that, okay, then I guess then none of this had an impact and they're just slowing on their own. In the gold market, the market got ahead, got up to the 1232 area, and it's pulling back. It can get down to that 18-week moving average of closes and see if it has support. It's not far from it. It's $3 away. That wouldn't surprise me at all. In looking at the chart, you can see how the pattern has broken, and you've broken through when we had a pennant pattern and all. You broke through the lows of that, and now we have a market that's leaking away. And in the process, you've got a pattern that's got a higher high left up here and a lower low. So then the question is, where are we in relation to key moving averages? You're under them today. Now, yesterday, if you take a look, you went to them, you bounced around between the 100 and the 18. Today, you caved in. It means resistance in the market is back up at the 18-day average, 1222.20, up to the 100-day average, 1228.60. What about potential support in the market? The most logical number is the lower Bollinger Band, and it's far away. It's right now around the 1192.90 level. That doesn't mean it has to go there, but that is where it's at. In terms of momentum, down, and not in oversold condition. So momentum down, the bias down because you're under the 18-day average, two levels of resistance above you. In the ETF of GLD, it's the same as the futures. Higher high, lower low, two levels of resistance now, 115.40 to 60. If it were to really let go, the lower Bollinger Band could be the support zone. The bearish market, but oversold, has been the miners. The GDX ETF, lower highs, lower lows, working its way down. I'd look for support to be formidable if the market got down to 1831. But it's all hands off come next Tuesday night on so many markets. We have to see, what do the Republicans retain in Congress? Do they keep the Senate? That's the bet. Will they be able to surprise the market and keep the House? If they lose the House, a lot of the key committees move away from their control and problems begin. So the real win would be if the president can win both of the House and Senate, and that would probably give the markets a whole different look than they'll get if he loses one of the House. And if he loses both the House and Senate, we have a whole different look coming at you. It's going to be a difficult night to hold positions. In the gold-silver ratio, it's still
not good for the base metals. Typically, gold gets a momentum move when base metals are moving with it. That's not the case here. Silver's just leaking away, oversold. It is caught in the overall black lines of the Bollinger Band, and each time you've gone to the top, you've pulled back. I have no reason to think that being down here won't result ultimately in another challenge of the 18-day average of closes. We are not in a trend. You have a higher high and a lower low. In the copper market, you are trending and you have let go through the downside, and this market has converted itself to just bearishness. Lower highs, lower lows. I realize it's oversold, but when you break out of the sideways action like you had here, you inevitably, either way you go, you get overbought or oversold, and the longer it starts riding this, which is what it's doing, it is not a good sign. This market still looks quite bearish. The market that's been a surprise to me has been the platinum as to how well it has stayed up, and it's done its job. It's in an uptrend, higher lows, higher highs. It's sort of waning. It's struggling to go anywhere. It's only up $1.90. You were up $12 in the palladium today, but you're still in a bearish market with lower highs, lower lows, although very oversold. I would say that the pros are lifting shorts in this market, and in the dollar, what's hurting the metals is obviously the dollar's locked in. And when the dollar locked in on this bullish trend, this is what you call riding that Bollinger Band. It's like copper, but the other way. See how it's just riding it? And in this case, you've got the embedded reading. So while people say, oh, it's going to break away, number one, it's not breaking away. People are uncertain. Which currency do you want to own going into the election? I'll leave that up to you. I'm not going to get into that argument. But here we are with but four, how many business days do we have left? Four business days after today of trading before we get into that evening's election. So far, the dollar is winning by fear. That's what I think is going on right there. Let's talk about these guide to technical indicators, because if you're watching me, that obviously means you're a technician or want to be a technician. And this is a great primer for you, a great primer. We had volumes 1 and 2. We did not put them together. We kept them separate. Our good friends at Modern Trader, the old Futures magazine, helped us with this, obviously, had their permission and put this all together. And this is just what they look like. They're in great color. They teach you what's going on. You get all these different ideas, spreads. You're going to learn contangos, backwardation. So many traders look at that. The Elliott wave theory in there. Options primer. A lot of people just trade options. Money management and the like. How do you get this? Because it's going to be a link that opens up for you. Call us, go to our website, sign up for it. We'll send out an email containing that for you, or just click up here and we'll make sure you get it. If you click up here, by the way, if you're watching me on YouTube, it'll take you right to the page you need, just as much as going to our website. I'm Ira Epstein. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.